Hello, Master Gardener. I'm at a client's house, and he was having some concerns that he believed he might have skunks, and then his dog got sprayed, and it confirmed that, in fact, he does have skunks. But he's seeing these little divots in the yard where they've been digging, and so he was asking what kind of controls there might be. Skunks are not an easy one to control. This could be skunk damage, it even could be raccoon damage. But because he smelled the skunk and it sprayed his dog, we know this is skunks. So I'm gonna show you the damage, and I'm gonna show you why I think his problem might be, I'm hoping he's at the end of that cycle. So let's take a look at the calendar and when the grubs come up in the soil. So this chart will show us, let's zoom in a little bit closer. See this calendar? It shows the months of the year, and here we are in June and July. At this time of the year, the grubs have surfaced to the ground within 1 inch of the ground surface. That's easy digging for a raccoon. Easy digging. And so that's probably what's occurring in his yard. Now, here's what a grub looks like. They're little C-shaped. The Japanese beetle grub is only about the size of a penny. And it's whitish and it has a brownish head. And if you don't know what a Japanese beetle looks like, well, there he is. I'm sure a lot of you have experienced lots of damage because they'll drill holes in all kinds of foliage plants. But at this time of the year, these grubs are up at the surface and then they're gonna start laying eggs and the grubs will come back in the ground in August and September. So he might see his skunks return during that time, but then they go down to 5, 6, 8 inches and they're real deep during the winter months. Therefore, the skunks and the raccoons won't waste their time trying to dig up any grubs. So what's the damage look like? I put little sticks at all of them, but here's some little holes. Now we had a heavy rainstorm last night, so a lot of these were filled in, but I kind of opened them up for you. So here's another hole right in here, sometimes 2 inches deep. Look, see, I can stick my fingers down in there, a 2-inch deep one. Look at some of the little holes over here. See my stick, another little drilled hole. So the grubs are grazing on the root systems of the grass. And as they eat the grass, oftentimes the turf will just peel right up. Here's another hole right here. And little holes here. Here's another little hole, 3-inch. So if you look across his lawn here, I got these little sticks, two little sticks. And I look out across here, you'll see a couple more little sticks where the skunks have been drilling in, digging up. So what are they looking for? Skunks will eat worms. They'll eat amphibians like toads and things. They love grubs. And so this is why they show up. Typically, I don't see them in lawns that are just kind of not tightly cared for. Oftentimes when people are putting down all kinds of fertilizer treatments on their lawns, it seems to me that I've noticed that they tend to be more prone to grubs, but not his lawn. And yet they're here drilling in holes. So a skunk is active all year around. So he's got them up in the hedgerow. Let me show you what his hedgerow looks like. So I'll try to move a little slower. So they come in, there's his hedgerow up there. He knows they're up in there. They live in old logs and old, they're volunteers in the respect that they'll go into little small shallow burrows in the ground that might've been dug by a groundhog and all. So they're living in the soil. They breed in February and March and then they have their babies. So right now, not only is the adult wandering around his yard, but also the little babies are wandering around here. I don't know that this would help you any, but if you were trying to figure out if you were having raccoons or whether you were having skunks, you might have put a little sand pile out here and check the tracks. The one way to tell the difference, the raccoon, here's a raccoon print. He has a long hind foot and he has a hand-like print. So that's your raccoon, whereas your skunk has lots of fingernails. Usually you don't see the nails on the back, but you see them on the front. You might confuse that a little bit with a kitty cat. Kitty cat though only has 4 toes. And if you ever had a possum track, he has a big thumb, a big forethumb. But those are kind of tracks that you could look for. But in his yard, there's no way among all this turf and this gill over the ground that you'd ever really be able to see the prints. So what do you do about raccoons? They're not an easy one to control. Hey, look, there's some more evidence that he's got raccoons. What is that? Can you figure out what that is? There's all kinds of cherry pits all in a pile. That's some old decomposed scat. Obviously, a raccoon or maybe a skunk has been eating around the neighborhood, eating cherries, and there's his little poopies. That's another good indicator that you've got a skunk. So what do you do about them? Usually what I'm gonna say is you're gonna try to control the grubs in the ground, which means oftentimes a chemical might be required in your lawn. Now, I don't always recommend that's the easiest thing to do. I don't want you to apply all those GrubX product, but that can give you some grub control in your lawn. Some people have tried to use cayenne pepper, and cayenne pepper is supposed to deter them. But honestly, I've seen in the websites, not everybody's having success with cayenne pepper. Some people have tried to lay deer netting on the ground and tried to discourage them physically with the netting. And that's been successful. There's some people that have laid tarps on their lawns overnight and tried to keep them out with tarps. The main concern, I guess, is that you might have rabies being carried into your yard. And that's the other concern with the gentleman with his dogs and all. We sure don't want rabies. They are a fur-bearing animal, so therefore he's not allowed to do a trapping system and haul them someplace else, because technically that is illegal in the state of Maryland. So I don't really have any great suggestions of how to get rid of those raccoons. Call a wildlife service is sort of what you're left to. Be careful. If they did have rabies, you would notice that they would be out during the day. They would have a kind of uncontrolled behavior. They might be aggressive. I had one attack my own horse one day. It was actually a raccoon came in and attacked my horses, and we had him tested for rabies, and sure enough, he had it. So try some repellents. They say things like ammonia-soaked rags can discourage the skunk from wanting to live inside your yard, but repellents might be it. Remove any kind of bird feeder or any feed. He knows that up under the tree up here, he's got some mulberry tree, so that's prime habitat up underneath of there. But that's the gist of having skunks in your yard. Not an easy one to control, but all those little drill holes that I'm finding here in his yard, that's the little rascals digging around. So there you are, Master Gardeners. A few fun facts about the skunk. Bye.